Hello, people. How are you? Welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial, I will explain to you how you can create these chips or snacks bags that you see on the screen using Blender 2.8. So let's start this tutorial. First thing that we need to know is to create a new scene. Okay. Let me just activate the shortcut keys. If you want to see which keys am I typing, you can see it on the left, on the right bottom of the screen. Okay. First thing that you need to do is to create a plane. So let's remove the default queue because we are not going to need it. Click with the right click of the mouse and then press the delete or the X key. Okay. Now let's go to the top view. Press 7 on your numpad to go to the top view and then Shift A to add a mesh and select plane. We want this plane to be in a rectangular shape, so press S to scale it and then Y to scale it on the Y axis. Maybe not on the X axis. Okay. S, X. That is good. I think this size is perfect. Let's create the texture. Okay. Go to the shading tab. Click on tab to enter in edit mode and then on this window here select UV editor. Now let's create the material for the bag. Click here on new, Shift A to add a texture and select image texture. I have already some image that I have made before. I have downloaded and placed it on my desktop. I will put it on the description of this video if you want to use it. And let's select one of them. Let's choose the blue. Okay. And then connect the color to the base color of the shader. Okay. Now that we have our texture created, we need to change some values here on the principal BHDF shader, but I will gonna make that later. First, let's go to the layout scene again. Press 7 to go to the top view, and then make sure that you are still in edit mode. Press with the right click of the mouse and then choose subdivide. Click here on the bottom left of the screen and select 50 number of cuts. Okay. Next thing that we need to do is to make those edges that the bags have on the bottom and on the top. And for doing that, let's select one and then let's select the vertices with one of interval. Okay. Let's select it. All that vertices at the bottom. Okay, now press S to scale it and Y, X, I'm sorry, that's not S. Let's press G. I want to grab them. Okay, G and then on the Y axis. Okay, that's good. Now that we have done this on the bottom, let's do the same on the top. Press 7 again if you have exited the top view. And then let's do exactly the same. Okay. Okay, now let's press G and not S, and then Y. That is good, that is perfect. And now, as you can see, we have the flat shape of the package. The next step is to give some extrusion to it, so that he can become more realistic, more look like a real bag. Okay, to do that you have to make some steps. The first one is to extrude this shape a little bit, so let's click on tab to go to edit mode if you have exit edit mode, and then press A to select all the vertices, and then E and Z. Okay, it just need a little bit, that is good. And then let's click on tab to exit the edit mode. Now let's another step is to add the close modifier. Okay, so to do that you can click here where it says context physics, okay, in this tab over here, and then select, let me just put this on top, and then select cloth. Okay, you can go here to the last to the bottom of the screen where it says fill weights, okay, and then select the gravity and push it down to the value of zero. Now that you have done this, click on Shift A again, select force field, and then the first one where it says force. It have opened some options here on the left. You need to change the strength value to 150 maybe, and then to see this effect or this modifier applied, we need to click on play button. Let's wait a little bit. As you can see, it is start to growing. Okay, you can choose to stop or play when you think that is good for you. That is a personal taste. Okay, you can choose more or less. For me, I think that we need a little bit more. Okay, that is good for now. And then let's select the box, let's go to the modifiers and apply the closed modifier. After you can only do this after you have make sure that the value is the extrusion is near of what you want as a final result. Okay, so for me that is good. I will choose apply, and then we need to add another modifier to smooth those faces over here. So let's click on add modifier and select the subdivision surface. Okay, I think that 3 is a good value. You need to pay attention, because if you increase this value too much, the processing capacity that your computer needs will be much bigger, so your scene may become a little slow. So please take that option with careful. Now that we have our bag, our final bag, let's click here on the preview mode. And as you can see, we have our first bag created. We can add some things to our scene, like a background plane, and check the lights. Let's do that. Shift A. Let's add a plane. Press S to scale the plane, and then enter the 50 value. Let's add a black material to the plane. So go to the shading tab. Make sure that you have the plane selected. Click on New. On the base color, let's choose black and let's increase the roughness to the top so that it will not reflect anything. As I told you before, in the beginning of this tutorial, I have said that we need to change some values here. I will increase the metallic value to maybe 0.4. Okay, and let's decrease the roughness to 0.1. Okay, so that it can reflect our lights on the scene. We are testing this using Eevee, but you can do that using Cycles. That works good too. Okay, you can use Eevee or you can use Cycles. If you use Eevee, you can change some values here to increase the quality of the render, like ambient occlusion and screen space reflections. Okay, I will place the other textures on the link on the description, as I said before, and you can use the blue, the purple, or the green texture. That is up to you. And then you just need to shift the duplicate the bags, okay, and then apply our textures, the green or the blue, or apply different textures in each bag. This was a very simple tutorial, but that can be very useful to you if you use Blender to make some packaging prototypes or mockups. I hope that it can be helpful to you, and thanks a lot for watching.